Oh yeah, we got a little bit of snow. It's kind of a light mix, but our hood, I mean, come on, you know? Maybe it's just a drift, but that's about a foot, I'd say at least. Pretty wild. Again, it is I who sits, but we had another load after that freeze. Thought I'd put a picture of my pickup on there so let you know what we were looking at, but it got extremely cold. Extremely cold into the negative. Anyways, my truck froze up and had trouble with it coming down DFW. I had to stop and get another filter put in. Now, I did take that filter off and I put some diesel and anti-gel in it. Put anti-gel on my tanks too, because my truck wasn't starting at first until I did that. You know, acting like it didn't have any problems. I guess I should have changed the filter on it. But, you know, to me it was really good. But sort of have problems with it on the way down. So last night I had to call a mobile mechanic to change the filter. Now, I had the water separator filter, so I went ahead and changed that myself. And, but I didn't have another filter. I figured that other filter was probably clogged. Got that change, got my power back, because I rolled into that truck stop off of 287. I rolled in there about 40 miles an hour. That's as much as I could do. Well, that road just kept getting worse and worse. I was losing manifold pressure. Manifold pressure, I would get up to 25, and then I would drop down to 10. And I was constantly having to get off the throttle and then get on it again just to get a little bit of power to make up the rules. But I made it to the truck stop. Called a mobile mechanic and he was gracious enough to come out and put a filter on me for a fairly good charge. Yeah. I mean, he did not overcharge me, but you have to understand when you call a diesel mobile mechanic out, you know, a lot of them, or most of them, rather than all of them. You know, it's a minimum 2-hour charge on labels. Yeah. Plus the filter, plus the mileage. Two and back. So about 40 something miles each way. We got another filter on, then I started getting another D-rate code coming back, but I made it to the receiver with an hour left on the D-rate code, and I hooked the computer up to it, and now it's saying that my differential pressure sensor is clogged up. So I took it off last night when I got in there about 1 o'clock in the morning. Took it off and tried to clean it up as best I could, but you know, it's clogged up, it's clogged up, that thing. Those are the insides that you cannot get to. There was a truck parts place over by this receiver, and they did not have a differential pressure sensor, nor a gas pressure, exhaust gas pressure sensor, which is right next to the differential pressure sensor, what a lot of people call, you know, delta P sensor. So I need to replace that, and I need to replace the orifice sensor right next to it. Cummins does not call it an orifice sensor. They call it a EGR gas pressure sensor. But it's right next to the, delta P sensor on this Cummins 2350. So, I have to get to this next drop. I got the first one. This load's already a day late because I was froze up the day from yesterday. I just got away yesterday. So. And hopefully, I think the D-rate code went away, but it seems like every time I drive a little bit, it comes back. And I hope that it's not going to get 5 miles an hour. Because I'm going more than 5 miles an hour right now, so I know it's not at 5 miles an hour. But yeah, I mean, maybe at 25%. now I cannot do a regeneration when he's coaching. And that worries me more than anything. Because if I can't get that done, then it will shut down. It'll shut the engine down pretty quick once it gets to a certain point. That's what I hate about these. That's what I hate about these EGR trucks. They will shut down on you. It doesn't matter where you're at, you know. At least on the older style, you know, they had a shutdown override where you could get to a safe place. On these, man, at least on this one, when that red light comes on, that motor is shutting down within 5 seconds. And you're going to put it on the side. So, yeah, we're dealing with some ice and snow today, but the highways are a little clearer now. 380 when I was coming over here was kind of looking like this and kind of slowed me down last night. And I had like 15 minutes left when I got to the receiver because I had to wait on the mechanic halfway in between. So halfway in between coming down here, I pulled over. I tried to take the filter off myself, but that gasket was messed up on it. I already taken it off twice. Leaking fuel, and plus I knew that filter was already still clogged. I never changed it. So hopefully we will make it to this next receiver. I think it's like 20 miles away or 25. So it's the Cisco there in Lewisville, I believe. Yeah, that's what we're gonna try to do. And there's not much room to park on the shoulders. Highway because of this ice and snow, so wish me luck. Well, as you can see, these side streets, they're lacking their former glory. We are approaching Cisco. EGR sensor. going to open up?
We will find out.
Oh, really? Oh, my goodness.
Yeah.
Shut down since yesterday, huh? Shut down since yesterday?
The what?
I said shut down since yesterday. Oh, okay.
The weather, yeah.
Any?
We got another system coming in tonight.
Another system?
Snow.
Oh,
bad
really?
Bad weather. We were going to be working the other day.
Oh, my goodness. So, we may not even open today then, huh?
Huh?
I said, we may not even open today then.
Oh, they're not opening at all today.
Oh, they're not?
Uh-uh.
Oh, wow.
They sent an email out yesterday. Said they got open today.
Uh-oh.
I'm gonna wait for them to call me about tomorrow.
Oh,
yeah?
Really? Can I leave my phone number?
Call that number right there.
Oh.
Around 12 o'clock today, and I'll find no.
All right. And that is, let's see.
This is the guard check. No.
Oh, it's a guard check. Okay. Well, at least they're letting somebody work.
Well, we ain't had no other stuff but work.
Oh, really?
And I just dropped that dog over there.
Okay, well, I will call it later on then.
Yeah, call me. I get up at 1 o'clock. Just call me around 12:30. And all I should have some news by then.
Okay, I appreciate it.
Okay.
System. I could be wrong, but take you along with me. I hope I have enough memory on my phone. This is so much fun. Get to sit here. I guarantee you, I need to go get some truck parts. And I need to go get a horse regen on this truck. This guy wants to know the 411. Yeah, they're closed right now.
They're closed, man.
Yeah.
Yeah, I just went in there. They're closed.
They may know about 1 o'clock. She said that she'll know something about 1 o'clock.
About 1 o'clock?
Yeah, but more than likely, they're going to be shut down for the day.
Yeah, but they're going to go to a truck stop.
You know where a truck stop is over here?
I'm going all the way back to Texas.
Oh, you are? Yeah, probably the best bet. But they got another system coming in tonight.
Yeah.
You know, but shit, I'm not gonna stay here.
I'm gonna park.
Huh? Yeah, use the bathroom. Yeah. Hell, you gotta get reefer fuel too.
Yeah.
You know. All right, peace. Send some messages and I might try to call dispatch, but I'll put an arrival on this drop. Arrive stop. Arrive stop. Okay. Yeah, they've been shut down, so it didn't matter if I got here yesterday. They were shut down yesterday too. I heard about that. You know, I heard Denton shut down from what that after hours dispatcher told me, but he wasn't, you know, I don't know if he didn't know specifically what shut down or he just didn't tell me, but they had to have been shut down yesterday because it was even worse yesterday. That's when all the snow was going on and all the wrecks and icing up on the road yesterday and the day before. So is what we're going to do is send an arrival message in. As what I'm doing is usually loads have load numbers specifically for each load, so I'm just putting an arrival at the stop for that for this load. Because if you have multi-stops, you'll usually do like arrive at the first stop, arrive at the next stop, and then your last stop will be your consignee. If you only have one drop, then that one drop is the consignee. I'll probably cut this part out with me putting this in here. I'm sure you don't want to hear blinkety blink with the computer. But anyways, we'll get back. Everything's shut down. It's a snowpocalypse. Not even the fast food joints are open. Come on. But hopefully this Peterbilt will be opened out here. We're over here off of Loop 12. Yes, we made it. We took the back roads. We took the back roads to get here. And they all look like this service road right here. The highways are one lane. Apparently Dallas DFW does not have any scrapers. I've not seen one scraper scraping any roads at all. Maybe they're doing I-20 and I-30, but I have yet to be on I-20 or I-30. That's all I know is I need to get over here to Peterbilt. Yes, we just came from Cisco and they were closed on a Tuesday. I figured out the date. It's Tuesday today. So we're closed on a Tuesday. Maybe close tomorrow too if they get a better system in. What that guard says. That's all I know is they're holding me up. They're holding up progress. They are holding up the progress. But hopefully Peterbilt's open. We can come down here and get the parts we need. If they're not too busy, I may try to get them to clear these codes.
Time to call that guard yet, so
just can't get into the shop, I'm gonna have them clear the codes over here. We're gonna do it that way. I'm tired of it. How about taking that?
Anything, you know. And I wonder
could go buy a mudflap at Freightliner, but that mudflap bar is bent, man. You're gonna need a sledgehammer to get that thing back to where it's supposed to be. I mean, I could try it. If I can bend it back properly, get it up there, then I might stop by Freightliner because it's just around the corner and get a mudflap. But I don't see how I'm gonna bend that angle iron back. I mean, it's a thin piece of angle iron, but it's still a piece of metal. But yeah, we're gonna get that done. Head on back to Cisco.